Welcome to Savita Dental College lecture cast in anatomy. The topic for discussion is ophthalmic artery, ophthalmic veins and the eyeball. Ophthalmic artery, it is a branch of internal carotid artery given off as it emerges from the cavernous sinus. The artery enters the orbit through the optic canal and lies inferolateral to the optic nerve. Then it runs superior to the nerve to reach the medial wall of the eyeball, where it terminates at the medial angle of the eye by giving off two branches, namely the supratrochlear and the dorsal nasal arteries. Branches and area of distribution of the ophthalmic artery. The first branch, namely the central artery of retina, is the smallest branch and an important branch only supplied to the retina. So whenever there is a blockage in the artery, it causes sudden blindness. It runs inferior to the optic nerve, sinks into the nerve 1 cm behind the eyeball and emerges from the center of the physiological cup and gives four branches, superior and inferior nasal, superior and inferior temporal branches. Posterior ciliary arteries enter posteriorly around the optic nerve and supply the choroid, whereas anterior ciliary artery arises from muscular branches, enter the eyeball near the muscle attachment. The posterior and anterior arteries anastomose and supply the iris, ciliary body and the deep conjunctival plexus. We can see the great arterial circle of Willis, the posterior and anterior conjunctival arteries and the anterior and posterior ciliary artery. The remaining branches are related to the branches from the ophthalmic nerve. The first one is the lacrimal artery, which supplies the lacrimal gland and the upper eyelid. It gives off zygomatic and a recurrent meningeal branch. Supraorbital branch passes above the levator palpebrae and ascends up to the scalp to supply it. Posterior and anterior ethmoidal branches passes through the respective ethmoidal canals distributed to the walls of the ethmoidal frontal and nasal cavity. The two terminal branches, the supratrochlear and the dorsal nasal, are distributed to the skin of the forehead, adjacent skin of the external nose. It also gives twigs to the muscles of the orbit. The veins of the orbit are the superior ophthalmic vein, inferior ophthalmic vein and the central vein of retina. The superior ophthalmic vein runs backward along the ophthalmic artery through the lateral part of the superior orbital fissure. It supplies the superior regions of the orbit, eyelids and forehead and ends in the cavernous sinus. It also has a communication with the facial vein through the supraorbital vein. Inferior ophthalmic vein again run along the inferior rectus muscle through the medial part of the inferior orbital fissure, drains inferior regions of the eyelids and orbits and end in cavernous sinus. It also has communication with the pterygoid venous plexus through the inferior orbital fissure. Central vein of retina is in the middle of the optic nerve behind the eyeball and leaves the nerve and ends in the cavernous sinus independently. The next topic is the eyeball. Each eyeball is a cystic structure kept distended by the pressure inside it. It has an anterior and posterior curvature and the maximal convexities on these curvatures are called as the anterior and posterior poles respectively. There are three coats of the eyeball, namely the outer fibrous coat, middle vascular coat and the inner nervous coat. The outer fibrous coat is dense, strong wall, protects the intraocular contents, anterior 1/6 is transparent, which is the cornea, and the posterior 1/6 is opaque, which is the sclera. The junction between the cornea and sclera, we term it as the limbus. Middle vascular coat contains blood vessels, which nourishes the eyeball, and consists of the iris, cornea, and the choroid. The inner nervous coat, it is concerned with the visual functions. It is thin, delicate layer, continuous posteriorly with the optic nerve. Opposite to the entrance of the optic nerve, a circular area is seen, which is the optic disc. Physiological cup in the optic disc does not have any rods and cones, and this spot we call as the blind spot. Posterior pole shows a depression called as the macula. The center of further is again depressed, which is called as the fovea centralis. This fovea centralis contains only cones, leading to maximum acuity of vision. Segments of the eyeball are the anterior and posterior segment. The anterior segment is again divided into anterior chamber and the posterior chamber. Anterior segment includes the crystalline lens, iris, cornea and the aqueous humor. Whereas the posterior segment includes all the structures posterior to the lens, namely the vitreous humor, retina, choroid and optic disc. Thank you.